So we have already done Act 2, Scene 2, and today we are going to start with Act 2, Scene 1, and today we are going to start with Act 2, Scene 2. This scene deals with the subplot of the play. That means the characters of the subplot, what happens to them, we will come to know in this particular scene. I told you that in each act, one scene deals with the main plot, the other one with the subplot. This is how Shakespeare writes his play. So, let's have a brief look at what all will happen in this scene. Caliban, bearing his logs, meets Trinculo. So Caliban, who was carrying his logs, he will meet Trinculo. He believes him to be one of the spirits whom Prospero sent to torture him. This is a kind of a funny scene. Right? So Caliban will think, because he has never seen Trinculo in the past, this is the first time that he will see Trinculo. And so what he will think? He will think that he is some spirit who has been sent by Prospero to torture him. Right? As a storm is blowing, Trinculo takes shelter under Caliban's cloak. So what will Caliban do? Because the storm was brewing, the storm was about to take place. And so what does Caliban, what does Trinculo do? Trinculo was unable to find any shady place to protect himself from the storm, to take shelter from the storm. So what does he do? Because Caliban was a huge monster. So he just hides himself inside Caliban's cloak. The two are lying together on the ground when Stephano staggers being drowned. So what happens when they were lying on the ground, both of them were lying on the ground, Caliban lay on the ground to protect himself from the spirit, that maybe the spirit just goes without torturing him. And Trinculo hides inside Caliban's cloak or dress or gabardine to protect himself from the storm. So when they were lying like this, what happens is Stephano passes that way, right? Stephano gives Caliban a drink because Caliban again was a strange looking ugly creature. And Stephano has never seen such a creature. So he gives him a drink. He feels, because Caliban was shivering, right? He was scared that the spirit will torture him. So he was just lying there with eyes closed and shivering, trembling. So Stephano thinks that he's suffering from fever. And so he gives him some wine to drink, right? The bottle from which he was carrying, he gives Caliban some wine. He feels that he's feverish, he is not well. So he gives him some wine. Taking him for a god, enters gladly into his service. Caliban, and what does Caliban think? Because Caliban feels that this is a divine drink which he hasn't tasted in the past. This is the first time that Caliban tastes wine. So he thinks that this is a divine heavenly drink. And so this person who is offering this drink, that is Stephano, should be some divine creature. He should be some god. And so he takes Stephano to be God and wine to be a heavenly drink. And so he very happily decides to enter into Stephano's service and leave the service of Prospero, because he thinks that now Stephano is the God and so he must be more powerful than Prospero. And so he can free him from the torture of Prospero. Right, and then later on they plan a conspiracy to kill Prospero and all these things happen, but not in this scene. So in this scene, the scene ends when he happily takes him to be God and enters into his service. The scene takes place in another part of the island. Enter Caliban with a burden of wood, a noise of thunder heard. So the sound of thunder is heard and Caliban is walking with a log of wood, right? Bundle of woods, rather. He was carrying a bundle of woods for Prospero, because Caliban used to work for Prospero, right? Prospero used to take all the heavy work from Caliban, right? So Caliban says, all the infections that the sun sucks, and he is carrying the bundle of wood which Prospero has instructed him for his fire, instructed him to bring for his fire. So while carrying, he is cursing Prospero, right? So this is the only thing which he does with his language. We have already read about it, that because Caliban uses his language only to curse Prospero. So he's going on cursing Prospero while carrying the bundle of wood. All the infections that the sun sucks up from box, fence, flats on Prospero fall and make him by inch meal a disease. So these are the curses which are being showered upon Prospero from Caliban. So all, he's talking to himself, right? Going on cursing. May all the infections mean may all the diseases which are present under the sun, which the sun is able to suck from the, which are present in the air. Why are they present in the air? Because the sun, along with all these dirty places, when the water evaporates, the diseases, the microbes which cause diseases, they are also present in the atmosphere. So may all the diseases which the sun sucks up from all these dirty places, that is the bogs, fens, flats, right? So that is the marshes and the shallows. Prospero fall and make him by inch meal a disease. May all these diseases fall upon Prospero. May all these diseases which are present under the sun, which are sucked by the sun, all the microorganisms which cause different types of diseases, may they fall upon Prospero and make him by inch meal a disease. And may every inch of him, may every bit of him be diseased. Every part of his body may be diseased, right? May they spread disease all over his body without even leaving an inch. His spirits hear me. So then he realizes that's because Prospero is a spirit, or the spirits who work for Prospero, they are all over the island, right? He is the ruler of that island, and so all the spirits on the island, they work for Prospero. So then he realizes that these spirits, they must be hearing him curse Prospero. He says his spirits hear me. So these spirits of the island, they are listening to me. I know they are listening to me. They are listening to these curses which I am blurting out for Prospero. They are listening to these curses, and yet I need must curse. But still, I'm so desperate that I cannot stop myself from cursing. I know these spirits are listening to me. I know this will prove disastrous to me. I know that after uttering these words, I will be tortured. I will be tormented by Prospero's spirits. But still, I cannot help cursing. Right? This is something which automatically comes to me, that I have to curse Prospero. I cannot control myself from cursing. But they will not pinch me. And then he realizes, but these spirits, they will not pinch me. Fright me with urchin's shoes. Urchin's shoes means hedgehogs. I've shown you the picture of hedgehog. Right? Hedgehogs are animals, like small animals, and they have a lot of pricks, you can say, on their body. So, pointed needle-like things on their body, right? So he says that his spirits hear me, yet I must curse, but they will not pinch. But then he realizes that his spirits will not pinch me, fright me with urchin shoes, nor will they scare me with urchin shoes, pitch me in the mire means, mire means mud. For the spirits, they used to push him in the muddy waters, in the dirty muddy water. So neither will they push me in the mire, nor lead me like a firebrand in the dark out of my way. What they will do, they will neither lead me like a firebrand. See, firebrand is like it's an insect also, and it's which is visible, which emits light in the dark, right? And it can be used for a lighted piece of wood, right? Piece of wood which is burning. So firebrand, and then it can be used for an insect also, right, which emits light in the dark. So lead me like a firebrand. So these spirits, what all they used to do, they used to transform themselves into firebrand in the dark out of my way. So in the dark, when the path was not visible, right, when the roads were not visible, roads, there won't be any roads in that uninhabited island. When the ways and the paths, they were not visible to Caliban. So what these spirits used to do, they used to start burning in the dark and then misguide Caliban, right? Caliban was used to walk on the right path, and then they would start burning and they would attract Caliban, and Caliban would start following those firebrands, which were the spirits, right? And then he was misled by these firebrands. In the dark, out of my way. So they used to misguide him by transforming themselves in the firebrand. So he says, neither will they do that unless he bids them. These spirits, they torture me only when he bids them, only when he instructs them, he orders or commands these spirits. So these spirits, they will neither transform into hedgehogs, nor they will push me in the mire, in the mud, nor will they start burning like firebrands to misguide me, unless they have been ordered to do so by prospect. But for every trifle are they set up. But the reality is, for every trifle means for every slightest mistake which I commit, for every little mistake which is committed by me, these spirits, they are let loose after me. Prospero instructs these spirits to torture me. For every small error or every smallest and slightest mistake which is committed by me. Sometimes like apes. See, these are the ways the spirits torture. Sometimes like apes. These are urchin shoals pitching in the mire. Misguide him then like a firebrand over this way. Right? So then he says that for every trifle are they set upon me, are they sent after me to torture me, sometimes like apes that mow and chatter at me and after bite me. So at times, what do these spirits do? On the instructions of Prospero, they transform themselves into apes or monkeys, and then they mow at me and chatter at me. Means then they make faces at me, and in the end they bite me. They take the shape of monkeys. First they chatter at me, monkeys chatter, right? So they chatter at me, make different kinds of faces at me, scare me, and after scaring me, finally they bite me. Then like hedgehogs. And what else they do? They transform themselves into hedgehogs, which like tumbling in my barefoot way. Because Caliban never used to wear any kind of slippers. So then what do they do further? They change themselves into hedgehogs, and then when I walk barefoot, they roll upon my way and I step over them, and then their thorns, they prick me, right? So they like tumbling in my barefoot way and mount their pricks at my footfall. And all of a sudden they would roll when I'm walking barefoot, and then they prick me. Their pricks, they go inside my feet because I step over them. Sometimes am I all wound with adders. Adders means the snakes, right? At times, what do? They take the shape of snakes and wrap themselves around Caliban's body, right? This is how Caliban is tortured by the spirits of Prospero, by the spirits which work for Prospero. At times, they change themselves into adders, that is snakes, and who with cloven tongues. Cloven means forked tongues. The snakes have forked tongues. So then they with cloven tongues to hiss me into madness. They wrap themselves, they take the shape of snakes and wrap themselves around Caliban's body, and then the forked tongue of the snake, they with their forked tongue, they hiss at him and drive him mad. Scare him into madness. And Caliban feels so scared that he goes crazy. Right? Lo, here comes a spirit. And then he sees someone approaching him. He says, see now, a spirit is coming. Prospero's spirit is coming to me. Why does he see? Whom does he see? He sees Trinculo. Right? Because Trinculo will be the next one to enter the scene. So he actually sees Trinculo because because he didn't know Trinculo. So he thinks Twinkilo to be one of the spirits of Prospero, right? Because he has never seen Twinkilo. He's seeing Twinkilo for the first time upon the island. And so he takes Twinkilo to be a spirit. So he says, "Lo, now lo. See, now again he's coming. Look, here the spirit is coming. He comes, here comes a spirit of his." His means Prospero. Here again, Prospero's spirit is coming and to torment me for bringing goods in stone. Now the spirit of Prospero is coming to me to torment me, to torture me. Why? Because I was late in bringing the goods. I was bringing the goods from the forest slowly. I was not fast enough. And so he has again sent this spirit to torment. I'll fall flat. Perchance he will not mind me. So he says, what should I do? He's trying to hide himself from that spirit. Both, it's Twinkilo, not the spirit. But again, he takes Twinkilo to be the spirit. And so to save himself, he wants, what does he do? He lies flat on the ground. He thinks that if I lie flat on the ground, there are chances. Perchance means there is some chance that he will not be able to notice me. He will not be able to see me and it will pass away from him. Right? So then Caliban lies down. Any problem till here? Now, Trinculo enters. And Trinculo enters, he sees Caliban lying on the ground, right? Scared, because he feels that Trinculo is the spirit sent by Prospero. Trinculo, he has neither bush nor staff to bear off any weather at all. And another storm came. So Trinculo sees that the weather again is not good. The storm is about to take place again. And so he looks here and there, trying to find a place to hide himself, to protect himself from this bad weather. So he says, then he finds that there is no bush and no shrub, no vegetation, no tree at all near him where he can protect himself. So he says that there is not even no shrub or no bush nearby to bear off any weather at all, to protect myself from any weather at all. And another storm came. And another storm is preparing itself. Another storm is about to take place. I hear it sing in the wind. And I can clearly hear the storm singing in the wind. Means I can hear clearly. See, the storm will not sing. The meaning is that he can clearly hear the sound of the wind. The winds, they were blowing very fast. Because of the fast blowing winds, the sound which is created, that is singing in the wind. The wind was singing. That means the wind was blowing at great speed. So that is why he could make out that another storm is about to take place. Yon, same black cloud. Yon means there in the sky, I can see the same black cloud. The same black cloud which brought so much rainfall, thunder, lightning a while ago, right? He came upon this island because of the bad weather and the shipwreck, which happened because of the bad weather, because of the tempest. So he says that again, I can see the same black cloud, yon huge one. There in the sky, I can see a big, huge black cloud. Looks like a foul bombard that would shed his liquor. Which looks like a large leather bag. See, in olden days, there were large leather bags in which the liquids were kept. They were used for containing liquid, right? For keeping liquid inside. So he says they were like treated like vessels. These large leather bags were treated like vessels. So he says this cloud. Here he is comparing the foul bombard, that is the large leather bag, to the cloud. Which figure of speech has been used here? Looks like a foul bombard that could shed. Same black cloud. Which figure of speech is used in these lines? Please. Can anyone tell?
Simile.
Because the cloud has been compared to the huge bag of leather, which was the huge leather vessel which was used for keeping liquor in those days. So which word shed is liquor, and it seems that the cloud is about to pour all the liquid again like a leather bag which is full of liquor, and it sheds, it pours its liquor. So if it should thunder as it did before, I know not where to hide my head. So, and if it again, if there is a thunderstorm again, like I saw in the past, like I saw some time ago, then I don't know where I'm going to hide my head, means where I'm going to protect myself from, where I'm going to take shelter, because there is not even a single tree or a shrub. Yon same cloud cannot choose but fall by failfall. He says such a huge black cloud, right, cannot choose. It doesn't have any choice. If I can see such a dark colored huge black cloud in the sky, it is quite obvious that heavy showers are approaching. There will be heavy rainfall. There will be thunderstorm. All these things are imminent. They will happen for sure. And then if this happens, then I don't have any place to hide myself. What have we here? And then when he was thinking all these things, all of a sudden he sees Caliban lying on the ground, right? And because Caliban was a very ugly, strange looking monster, so Trinculo must have not seen any creature like him in the past. And so he says, what have we here? Now, what is this here in front of me? A man or a fish? Is he a man or is he a fish? Because he was half fish, half man, right? Dead or alive. And because he was lying there still without making any kind of movement, so Trinculo says, is this creature dead or is it alive? Whether he's a man or whether he's a fish. A fish. He smells like a fish. So then he says, he's definitely a fish because he is smelling like a fish. A very ancient and fish-like smell. And not even like a fresh fish. He's smelling like a very stale. Ancient means very old. And stale. For in this particular case, it would mean stale. As he has a very stale fish kind of a smell. So I'm sure he's a fish. He is not a human being. A kind of knot of the newest Poor John. So Poor John is a type of a saltwater fish. Right? It's the name of a saltwater fish. So he says that definitely he doesn't smell like Poor John, like a fresh Poor John, right? He smells like a stale ancient fish. And if it is a fish, then it is a strange kind of a fish. And then he starts thinking that were I in England now, if I would have been in England at the present moment, as once I was, as I used to live once upon a time, and had but this fish painted, then what would have I done? Then I would have taken this fish to England, got him painted, and then kept him for exhibition kind of thing, for people to look at him. Not a holiday fool there, but would give a piece of silver. So then I will just keep him on display. I would have kept him on display. I would have, and I would have charged money from people for having a look at him. Not a holiday fool. Holiday fool means all the fools whose only job is to enjoy holidays, right? All the fools who are only holidaying. So not a holiday fool there, but would give a piece of silver. So I'm sure that every fool who is only enjoying holidays, he would definitely give me a silver coin for having a look at him. He's such a strange creature, and I will make him even more strange by painting him, make him more attractive, and then keep him on display. There would this monster make a man. And then what would happen? Then this strange monster will make a man. Make a man means make the fortune of a man, like me. What will happen? He will start earning money, right? People will come, they will have a look at Caliban, right? And then they will pay silver coins. And so this monster will make a man. Make a man means will make the fortune of a man, will make a man rich or wealthy. Any strange beast there makes a man. In a country like England, any strange animal makes the fortune of a man, makes a man rich. when they will not give a doit. Doit is a small amount of money, right? As a small penny to relieve a lame beggar. The people of England, they will not spend. They are such stupid people that they don't spend even a doit to relieve a lame beggar. They will not spend even the smallest amount of money by giving that money to a lame beggar, to a handicapped beggar. They won't give any amount of any money to a lame beggar. But for such stupid things, but for such foolish things, they are ready to spend silver coin. They will lazy out 10 to see a dead Indian. Dead Indian means red Indian. See, they, because the people of Europe, they had a different complexion and looks. So these red Indians, they were considered as rare things, right? So the people, they were ready to, and these red Indians were the basically the aboriginals of America, right? You know that Christopher Columbus discovered America, thinking it to be India, right? So the people of the aboriginals or the natives of America, they came to be known as red Indians, right? Because they were dark complexion. You must have read in Chief Seattle's speech. So he says that will lazy out 10 to see a dead Indian. Means they will spend 10 coins to see a red Indian because it looks strange, it looks weird, it looks different, but they will not give a penny to a lame beggar. Leg like a man. And then he further says that this creature is leg like a man, means he has the legs of a man and his fins like arms, and his arms are like the fins of a ship. So you can say that he was a blend of a fish and a man. So, but his arms are like fins of the fish. Warm, oh my God. And then what does he do? Trinculo goes further and he touches Caliban. When he touches Caliban, he says, but his body is warm. Normally the body of a fish is cold, right? The fish's body is not warm. And so when he touches Caliban and he finds his body to be warm, he says, oh my God, I do now let lose my opinion. Hold it no longer. He says, now I would like to change my opinion. It doesn't hold true. This cannot be a fish because his body is warm. So, oh my God, his body is warm. So this cannot be a fish. I would like to change my earlier opinion because it doesn't hold any longer. It doesn't hold true any longer. The opinion which I formed about this creature a while ago, now I would like to change that opinion. This creature is not a fish. He is definitely an islander. Islander means the person living on this island. So he is someone who belongs to this island. He is not a fish. That had lately suffered a thunderbolt. And because Caliban was lying in a strange manner, lying flat on the ground. And so Trinculo feels that he must have been struck by a thunderbolt, lightning. And so that is why he is lying there. Fainted, collapsed because of the thunderbolt. So says, alas, the storm is coming again. And then he hears the sound of thunder. He says, oh, the storm is coming again. My best way is to creep under his gabardine. And so the only way I can save myself, looking here and there and not being able to find any space to hide himself, to protect himself from this bad weather, what he decides is, because Caliban was a huge monster, so he thinks that the best way to hide himself at this moment would be to go inside his cloak or the gabardine which he was wearing. He says the best way is to creep under his gabardine. So the best way will be that I should go inside his dress, Caliban's dress. There is no other shelter here, about because there is no other shelter here at this place. So I would better go inside his cloak. Misery acquaints a man with strange bedfellow. So unfortunate times, difficult times, right? What do? They force a person to sleep with a strange bedfellow. So it's because he's referring to Caliban. He says, now I will have to take shelter in the gabardine of this strange creature. See, why? Because I am in a difficult situation. So I want to protect myself from this difficult situation. So I will have to even hide into his dress, which he was wearing. So Then he says that misery acquaints. Misery forces a man to sleep with strange fellows, strange creatures. I will hear shout till the dregs of the storm be past. Then he says that I will hide myself, I will cover myself by hiding into his dress till the last remains. Dregs means the last remains. Till the last remains of the storm have passed. And then he creeps inside Caliban's garment. He moves inside, he goes inside Caliban's dress, the dress which he was wearing. Enter Stefano singing a bottle in hand. I think we should stop here and we'll continue further on the next time. If you have any problem, you can ask.